What do you think about this, David?
So starting with Roomba, I would put Roomba in the bottom left. It definitely acts in the world, but it definitely doesn't act like I do. It crisscrosses across the floor until it vacuums everything up. So we're going to say that's acting optimally. C-3PO is fluent in over 6 million forms of communication, and that means that it interacts with humans and other species very often. In order to do that, it has to understand natural sentences and put its own knowledge back into natural sentences. So it has to act like humans. Apple's virtual assistant, Siri, doesn't act in the world, so she's more on the thinking end of the spectrum. But like C-3PO, she has to interact with humans. She has to read human sentences, and she has to put her own responses back into normal vernacular. So we're going to say that she thinks like humans. Google Maps plots your route from your origin to your destination, so it's definitely doing thinking. It's not doing any acting in the world. But we really don't care if it does the route planning like we would do it. So we would say it does its route planning optimally. It takes into consideration traffic, current construction, and different things like that, whereas we would probably think of the routes we've taken in the past. So Google Maps thinks optimally.
That's a good answer, David. I agree with you. But note here that some aspects of Siri may well belong to some of the other quadrants. So putting under three sounds plausible, but Siri might also be viewed as perhaps acting when it gives you a response. Some aspects of Siri might also be optimal, not necessarily like humans.
So if you'd like to discuss where these technologies belong in these spectrums, or perhaps discuss where some other AI technologies that you're familiar with belong on these spectrums, feel free to head on over to our forums, where you can bring up your own technologies and discuss the different ways in which they fit into the broader school of AI.